Throughout the last decade, we've seen some horrible money in the bank cash-ins. John Cena being the first to fail because of a disqualification was stupid. Damian Sandow being completely buried after failing to defeat John Cena for the World Heavyweight Championship was also very bad. And Baron Corbin personally never recovered since his loss. He went from being WWE Championship material to never being in that conversation. However, I think that WWE just gave us the worst Money in the Bank cash-in I've ever seen last night with Austin Theory. This has to be Triple H's biggest L since taking over as the head of creative. I really can't believe that he greenlit this idea. Like, it's crazy. The entire thing made Austin Theory look like a fool and it was poorly booked. Let me explain why this was the worst cash-in of all time. I understand that Roman Reigns is the undisputed WWE Universal Champion and Austin Theory wasn't going to beat him for those titles. However, cashing in on the US Championship is probably one of the worst decisions. The crowd didn't even care that much. Usually, the cash-ins get a thunderous reaction from the people in attendance, and while he somewhat got a small pop, it was nothing compared to every other surprise cash-in. Look, I get it. WWE is clearly trying to bring prestige back to that championship because Triple H envisions the mid-card titles feeling as important as the world championships. And they've done a good job. Look, Bobby Lashley was a great US champion. I will agree with that. And Seth Rollins being the second title holder while Triple H has been booking things was a genius decision. However, the Money in the Bank should not be cashed in on that belt. If you have the opportunity to use that briefcase and cash it in whenever you want, wherever you want, on whoever, you chase the WWE title. It makes no sense to use it for the US title. It makes even less sense when you realize that Seth Rollins issued a US title open challenge. If Austin Theory really wanted that belt, he could have just made his way into the ring against Seth Rollins because, like I said, this man literally asked anybody to come down to the ring. Why would you waste your golden ticket on something you could have already had? This makes Austin Theory look incredibly stupid, and it's kind of insulting to fans watching the product. How stupid do you think we are not to recognize all of this that's happening in our face? It was such a bad decision. What makes the entire thing so much worse is that he didn't even successfully cash in. So Austin Theory didn't cash in on Roman Reigns because he was afraid he would lose that match. Okay. Then he didn't accept the US Open challenge because he didn't want to take on a healthy Seth Rollins, I guess. So he decides to use his Money in the Bank on a weak US champion and still fails to win the match. Like, bro, that is just straight up embarrassing. Triple H destroyed the credibility of the Money in the Bank briefcase. But more importantly than that, he destroyed the credibility of Austin Theory. The dude was having such a good run with Vince McMahon in charge. I really thought he was going to be the next big thing. And Triple H just destroyed this kid's career just like that because it wasn't a fan of him like Vince. It doesn't matter. Theory was getting some of the loudest reactions a few months ago. As a heel, I'd say he was probably drawing the most heat, and it was slowly being flushed down the toilet in the last few months, but this was the final nail on the coffin. Austin Theory has been buried. He's a joke, and so is the Money in the Bank briefcase. I know there are going to be people defending this decision saying you've got to wait it out and see where it goes, and I'm usually the person who says that and tries to do that the most, but I can't even defend this garbage. This was so bad that I can't make an argument for it, and that's when you know that you really messed up big time. This was a terrible decision. It's so strange that this is what WWE decided to go with because there were so many other options. I personally wanted to see Austin Theory cash in on Cody Rhodes after he won the belts from Cody Rhodes to take away that big moment away from Cody. WWE could have booked The Rock versus Roman Reigns in the first night's main event of WrestleMania, and then Cody Rhodes would take him on in the second night's main event, but for both world titles. After Cody wins the belts, can you imagine the nuclear heat that Theory would get coming down to the ring and taking those belts from Cody? Heck, Rhodes could have even retained and it still would have been a better decision. To have Theory show up at WrestleMania in the main event and fail would have been the perfect way to reintroduce him as a face. A loss of that magnitude could have sent him down a new path to start improving himself or something like that. There were more stakes to it, but this man instead really failed on a random episode of Raw for the US title. Like, what? Who thought that was a good idea? A WrestleMania cash-in, successful or not, would have been significantly better and more important. But those weren't the only two choices. A loss against Roman Reigns would have been fine as well. Like I said, it does not matter that he lost. It just matters that he lost for the US title. Losing to Roman Reigns would have honestly protected him more. To be quite frank, him dethroning Roman Reigns could have been good as well. He would have instantly become a top guy. That would have made him a superstar. Isn't it better to use the Money in the Bank briefcase to make new stars rather than to just waste it? Okay, let's say we don't want him to end the historic Roman Reigns title reign with a cash-in. I get it. A cash-in on the NXT title would have been infinitely better as well. Bron Breakker has been a good champion, but he doesn't need that belt. Austin Theory winning the belt and staying in NXT could have worked, and then Bron Breakker could have been called up to the main roster. Assuming WWE didn't want to end that reign, I understand that as well. But if it seems so confusing and you really didn't know what to do that you panicked and did this, then WWE should have done nothing about it. Just wait until after WrestleMania 39. A storyline of Austin Theory panicking because his time is running up would have been a lot of fun. And you know what? Maybe the problem was that Triple H didn't want him to win in the first place, but that's fine. Austin Theory was picked to win the contract before he was in charge. If he really wanted to, Hunter could have booked him in a match for that briefcase with someone else winning and being the holder of that briefcase. Kevin Owens could have won it. Edge could have beaten him for it to have one last world championship run. Finn Balor would have been a better holder since he's thriving right now with the Judgment Day. And even someone like Sami Zayn would have been another interesting name who could have taken it off of his hands. Giving him the Money in the Bank contract would have spiced things up with the Bloodline. As you can see, I just named a bunch of different options and WWE decided to go with the worst one possible. Like, I just don't get it. I don't really know what's next for Austin Theory after this failed cash-in. I'm assuming he's going to have a storyline similar to Baron Corbin when he was a loser. I could even see JBL and Corbin trying to recruit him to be a part of that group, but like, that's kind of whack too. You go from being a world champion to pairing up with Corbin and JBL, like what? But even if that happens, all of this is just very disappointing for Austin Theory and also for the fans, because a lot of people, well not a lot, but some people thought Theory could have been a great future young champ. And you know what? WWE and Triple H really dropped the ball with this one. Austin Theory could recover. I'm not saying this is the end of his career because it's not. It just sucks that it had to happen like this. Even a cash-in at WrestleMania and dropping the belts back to Cody the next night on Raw could have worked. Like, literally anything could have been better than this. Hopefully, WWE will try to bring prestige back to the Money in the Bank contract and not give it out to someone who isn't in their long-term plans, because goddamn, this was just terrible. Anyways, that is it for the video, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.